The 2020 HMIS Data Standards Manual and the 2020 HMIS Data Dictionary can be found on the HUD Exchange website at hudexchange.info/resource/3824/HMIS-data-dictionary/. To access the documents, please click on the PDF links shown below. The HUD Data Standards Manual is intended to be read in conjunction with the HMIS Data Dictionary. Together, the 2020 HMIS Data Standards Dictionary and Manual contain the foundation for the data that's contained within a homeless management information system known as HMIS. Project setup instructions, data collection instructions, program-specific meanings and definitions, and key information that the federal partners have identified as required for their program. This manual is designed for COCs, HMIS lead agencies, HMIS system administrators, and HMIS users to help them understand the data elements that are required in an HMIS to meet the participation and reporting requirements that are established by HUD and the federal partners. HMIS has a unique features and was built to meet the different data collection needs for each community. The client doesn't know or client refused responses should not be used to indicate that the case manager or data entry person does not know the client's response, nor are these responses to be assumed without first asking the client to provide the information. Some clients may decline to provide responses to some fields, but case managers or data entry staff may not make that decision for them. HMIS users can benefit from this document as it provides guidance and instructions on why the data is being collected, at what point in time should the data be collected, from whom the data should be collected from, and detailed instructions on how the data should be entered into HMIS. Programs can benefit from using HMIS. Not only are they able to report information about a project or a client, but they can capture information about the data itself, when it was collected, when it was entered in HMIS, and who entered it, and which project is responsible for it. From the table of contents, you can click on any data element and it'll take you directly to that section. You should read it in its entirety so that you have a clear understanding of how you should be entering the data into HMIS to avoid any data quality errors. And if you scroll down further, you'll also see that for each field in HMIS, you'll have a description that'll give you clear instructions on what to collect and what to enter. And for each data element, it'll also ask you to provide a data quality. And as you can see here under the description, it'll give you a full description for each of the data quality options that you will see in HMIS. To ensure that your program is maintaining good data quality, we suggest that you run the HMIS data quality report so that you can identify any discrepancies and make the corrections in HMIS.